How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Brick Science. My name is Riley. Today we're going to be building a working automatic Lego mini pizza vending machine. Basically, it's going to be a machine built with Legos and Mindstorms that when you put coins in, it's going to assemble a mini pizza that you can then go cook in your oven or just eat because it's already cooked ingredients. There's this YouTuber called Astonishing Studios who builds incredible Lego vending machines and candy machines. Let's see what he has to say. All right, guys, I'm here on the phone with Marcel from Astonishing Studios. He's going to give me some tips on how I can build my own Lego food machine. So, Marcel, what's the first thing you do when you start a new candy machine? Like, do you work out the mechanism or you set down the base plate? Like, what's your main go-to when you get an idea?
Yeah, I first try to think of the mechanism for that machine and how I'll achieve it. And I do that first by sitting down with a bunch of Lego plates and figuring out what's the minimum base plate I can work with. I'm sure you've already realized that something that looks small with Lego can take many hours to build just with how small Lego bricks are. So that's why I really try to emphasize the machine being compact before I start building anything else like the decorations.
What's the best example you can think of building a coin rejection mechanism? Like, what's the best working way to do that?
Yeah, so one that I commonly do, so you're welcome to reference my videos, is just a system that rejects them by diameter. So we'll have like a little slope or a slide that the coins can slide down, not roll down, but just simply slide down on a face. And ideally, you can have it be a ramp, and then there's two rails, which ultimately means that that slope has a hole that should be a diameter big enough for, say, like pennies and dimes and nickels to fall through, but those rails should be just close enough so that a quarter can go through.
All right, so this is some of the stuff I'm gonna be using. I've already built a few things, but I have a plan here. Basically, we have a conveyor belt, and this is gonna have the pizzas on it. One of the motors is gonna spin this. The first time the pizza stops, it's gonna get sauce, which is where the syringe comes in. That takes the conveyor belt, we'll move it a little more towards this area here, and that's where the toppings are gonna go on. So we're gonna have three different toppings, cheese and sausage, cheese and pepperoni, and just regular cheese. The way that's gonna work is there's gonna be a little tray that goes across with three containers, and you can choose which one you want. And this all happens after you pay. So basically this is where the quarter goes in here, and it's just wide enough so it rides those rails there. But then anything smaller than a quarter will fall through this little hole, and it gets rejected, so it gets sent back to the person. Also, this is the brain right here. All the motors are gonna plug into this, and then this is what's gonna tell the machine how many quarters have been put into the machine and where to move all the motors at the different times. Let's get started. Okay, the button mechanism is finished. You push it, this takes over. We go to our next stage, which is the sauce. So we'll need to mount this about here. It's kind of just gonna dispense sauce in a little pile, but we work with what we got, okay? Gosh. Let's do this, guys. Let's do it. So excited. Oh. Back to the mystery box. And as you know about the mystery box, it's always a mystery what we'll find in here. Genius idea, scaffolding. We'll use our collection of doors to get some scaffolding built up. So now what we gotta do is we gotta build up underneath this, just a few bricks where it's gonna connect, so this might be actually pretty easy. Nice. Hopefully this won't be too top heavy, but we'll see. Oh yeah, guys, look at that. That's pretty sturdy. It's just because of this thing, the plate, but it's actually really sturdy. So when this is filled up with sauce, it will go up, this will connect, and then this motor will spin, dispense just enough sauce for this pizza. It's gonna take it forward to the toppings. That's actually a good point. I'm gonna need to move this motor. The way that the topping selector is gonna work, we're gonna have a piece that slides across, so it's gonna have a little knob in the front. The way this is gonna work is that, let me build it up with scaffolding first. This is too hard to explain. All right, now we got this up. Now, the toppings. Basically, we're gonna have two plates that are just standstill, and then the third plate in the middle is gonna be a retracting plate. That's what the motor is gonna motorize. So when this thing slides, no matter where it slides, all these will still stay up, unless the middle one goes over the retracting plate, in which case these two will still stay up because of the side plates, and this one will fall down, dropping the ingredients. Hopefully that's how it works. If it doesn't, I'm gonna cry. All right, now we're gonna test this. It's in there, it's ready to go. We wanna make sure everything's plugged in because I don't wanna have to do this twice. Here we go. We're gonna start the project. Project is going. Now, the first thing we gotta test is to make sure, first of all, we gotta make sure that it's in the right place to be dispensed. Right there. Okay, this is on. And I just wanna make sure when you push this button, it doesn't go. Right, when you push the button, it doesn't go. That means you need to dispense not one quarter, but two quarters. So here's one. Still shouldn't go. All right, here's two. Now it should go. Yep, sauce. Keep going. Yes. Guys, success. Did you see this? Okay, just a little close up for the camera here. This is a pepperoni pizza. It's got the sauce, it's got the pepperoni, it's got the cheese, okay? So that's our first successful one. We're gonna reuse this crust, okay? Successful. We wanna try this again. This time I'm gonna show you how we can get a different type. All right, we got our coins back and I wanna show you coin rejection. So nickels don't go through and pennies don't go through, but two quarters, take this all the way to the back. And now we want to make sure we have the right one selected. So I want sausage on my pizza. There we go, that slides it over. And now we're going to push the button and pull. Here we go. Yeah, come on, you got this. Yep, yep. Here we go. Sausage pizza. Heck yes, dude. This is our sausage pizza. It's got cheese, it's got some sausage. Obviously, I could have filled up this thing a little more. But hey, what if you just want a cheese pizza, you know? What if you just, what if that's all you need? Just a cheese pizza, right? You take this out, you get your coins back, you slide this over to cheese, and the mechanism is gonna put the plate right over where it's gonna fall. So here we go, two, nice, push, pull, nice. It's right over there. Now we got a cheese pizza. Perfect. Here's our nice cheese pizza. As you can see, this is like a Lunchable size pizza. And this thing has worked phenomenally well. I'm gonna have to say it works super well. It's a messy machine. The programming was tough. It was really tough to create, but I did use a lot of Marcel's tips. So I wanna give a big thanks to Astonishing Studios for helping me with this project. And I also wanna see what he thinks about it. So let's show him.
Riley, that was fantastic. I really like the three Lego pizzas you had for each option. They were designed truly in a way that represents what you do as somebody who builds superhero relevant creations. I really liked as well how you were able to like just go into Lego automation and really do a phenomenal job. The conveyor belt was super satisfying to see. The gear rack powered syringe was super satisfying, especially with that, you know, sound effect you had in there. The cheese avalanche was a bit messy. I wish you could have filmed that at a different angle. It would have just made it, you know, look a little more appetizing. And just the way it got dispensed in such an efficient amount of time was really nice to see. The only critique I really hold is that the color dark gray navy didn't go well with the rest of the machine. I can understand if you don't have red tiles or if it would have taken you too long to find them if they're, say, in like an unsorted Lego bin. But overall, that was really cool. Thank you for even like showing people like me what can be done with Lego machines. You really taught me something there. And thank you so much for, you know, just having me on the show. All right, watch more Brick Science. Let's go.
Well, guys, thank you so much for watching. This was really fun to build. If you enjoyed, go check out Astonishing Studios. His channel is awesome. He inspired me to get into Lego in the first place, so I want to give a big thanks to him. And go check out his videos. Subscribe down below. And make sure you hit that bell icon so you don't miss any of my future uploads. I'll talk to you guys on the next Brick Science.